Bismillah ar Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. So many of you know that for a good few weeks now, I have been promoting this course about saving our Iman called How to Save Our Iman in Today's Climate. I believe that we're facing a crisis of faith, which is completely unprecedented. According to a survey in America by Pew Research, 23% of Muslims born into Islam no longer identify themselves as Muslim. Now, if that's not a crisis of faith, I don't know what is. And honestly, if the same survey was done in the United Kingdom or any other place in the West for that matter, I wouldn't be surprised if things turned out to be the same or similar or perhaps even worse. Now, let's just quickly take a moment to reflect on that statistic. Wherever you are, count four people. According to this statistic, roughly one of those four people is a non-Muslim. You probably don't know it. They probably haven't admitted to it. But secretly, they have left Islam and have most likely chosen atheism because they don't believe in Islam anymore. So what can we do about it? Most people are facing a crisis of faith because there are things in their lives that are bringing their faith into question, that are causing a crisis of faith. However, they do not have the knowledge about their religion to be able to deal with these problems that and these challenges that they are facing in their lives in a way that doesn't affect their faith. And for some people, the reasons for questioning their faith are intellectual, to do with science, to do with the question of evolution. There are philosophical questions. There are problems that, to do with the problem of evil, etc., that they have been mulling over in their heads intellectually. They don't have the Islamic answers to these things because they've studied in madrasa, but these things have not been addressed. When they go to the imam, they go to the masjid, these things are not addressed. When they sit at home and discuss, if ever religion comes up, these things are not discussed. And they build up an assumption for different reasons that Islam doesn't have the answers. So the solution is actually for everyone to understand what Islam has to say about evolution, what Islam has to say about the idea out there in the atheistic world that religion is dead, that God is dead, that we don't need religion anymore, that science answers all of our questions, that science explains reality better than religion does. Questions around, if God is loving and if we have a just God out there, then why is there so much suffering in the world? And why are there natural disasters? And why is this and why is that? Now, I guarantee you there are answers to these questions, good answers to these questions. But the problem is that most people don't know, haven't taken an interest, or even if they know that there may be an answer in there, the answer hasn't been presented to them in a convincing way. They haven't been allowed the time and space to reflect on those answers and to make those answers their own. Because sometimes it isn't good enough just to hear an answer from somebody else. You have to reflect on that answer and then understand it in your own terms. It's really to address all of this that I've launched this course, How to Save Our Iman in Today's Climate, where I hope, inshallah, that in four sessions, that I will be able to introduce faith in a way to the average Muslim that will address these questions. And inshallah, that will equip both the person who is convinced with the answers to be able to articulate faith in a better way, to be able to engage in conversation with their children, with members of the community, with their friends and family, in a way that will make them feel validated about their faith and about being a mu'min, being a believer. And for people who have questions, people who are wondering, do I believe in the right thing and so on, it will answer many of their questions. Brothers and sisters, let's face it, right? Most people believe as followers, right? They believe because they were born into Islam. Now, most of our theologians say that this is okay, meaning people who believe in that way, their faith is valid. But this is not the preferred position to be in. The preferred position to be in is to be an informed believer. And this course, although it won't give us all of the details, It will make us an informed believer. It will present to us the answers to the basic questions, and it will give us enough resources, enough reading, and you'll be signposted to enough material to be able to go on and learn more. And inshallah, we will follow up with more courses. So in January, 4 Saturday mornings, and then there is an option to do some afternoon sessions as well. You see that on the website. 4 Saturday mornings, all of the lectures will be recorded. So people who for whatever reason cannot attend a lecture live will be able to catch up with a recording. The idea is, inshallah ta'ala, for this course to give people confidence in their faith, to make people feel validated as believers, as well as equip them to be able to address questions and challenges against faith out there that are flying around, that have affected so many people, that almost a quarter of Muslims have left or are considering leaving Islam. So I look forward to seeing you in the course, inshallah ta'ala. Look up the details on the website, www.mawaridlifestyle.com/courses. I hope that this is going to be the beginning of a movement to try to tackle this crisis that we're in. Jazakumullah khairan. Wassalamu alaikum.